Hello, Risk aficionados. Welcome to Shoulder Tap. We have a very special treat today in that the legend himself, Mick, the manager of Risk, is back from his little roundabout Europe. So how's it been? First time seeing you, Mick.
Yeah, it's good to be back. I feel like I'm going to be a little rusty here. I was telling a couple of you guys I was nervous. You know, it's been almost a month since I've done this. And, you know, Brett, Ben, doing the Shoulder Tap coverage, you know, some big shoes to fill there. But I'm happy to be back. And, yeah, I'm ready to do this. Today's Roast My Trades. We've got two regular cards, and then we've got one guy that we want to roast. I guess before we get into it, though, Jack. Yeah, before we get into it. Yes, I do. So I'm not in the office today. I'm working remotely from home at my old man's place. And here in his office, when I set up my computer this week, I was looking for a mouse pad, and I was rummaging through his desk drawers, snooping around, and I found some old gems, the old trading badges, and I thought that was kind of funny because, you know, I know the mustache is kind of a trait of mine on the Shoulder Tap and whatnot. We get a lot of commenting on it, and you know, I call this my dad stash. Ever since I had my daughter 16 months ago, I had the stash going, and it's because, you know, when I was younger, all my childhood pictures, my dad had the mustache. Even my wife, her father had the mustache. So and we did a photo. I think I snagged something that we shared as my dad on the trading floor years ago. But I found a couple of his old badges with the mustache. So I wanted to show some of those pictures. I think there's one from 84 and 91. Yeah, this one kind of looks like El Chapo there. You know?
Yeah, definitely.
So that's the 84 one. And then we've got the 91, a little tattered and battered here. There is a newer one. I don't know if we need to show that. But with those badges and the images, I wanted to see if we could do a poll in the chat here to, I don't know, see who wore it better, wears it better, wore it better. He doesn't have it anymore. I've got it, though.
Yeah,
I think I'm going to need to keep this for like 7 years at least.
Exactly. Yeah, so like, James, let's get a poll in chat. Who has the better stash? Jay or Mick? We'll check that out. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Well, I was saying while we're waiting for those to roll in, how is our board looking today? I can think of one live account that is not doing well.
Yeah, there's a couple live accounts not doing well. And believe it or not, I know you're referring to the house account that's, you know, taking some damage today. While this is not someone that we're going to actually roast as trades, I'm on the card at the end of this. I got a roast for two individuals particularly, both so happen to be Raphaels. Raphaels in the live accounts, I'm going to roast them. These are shoulder taps, not shout outs. We had Raphael S earlier today up $1,400. He was in the S&Ps at the time. He was up he was up $14,000, Jack. And I was watching him ride a 15 lot out. I was going against him at the time. It was against him 8 grand. So he went from being up 14 grand to up 8 grand on the day. Excuse me. Up 6 grand on the day. And then, you know, there was that big spike to the upside. And with the 15 lot on, he turned a $14,000 winning day into a $5,000 losing day. $19,000 swing in very short order. You know, that always hurts. He's one of our traders on the leaderboard, I know, because he's got almost 140 grand in the account. But, you know, this was still over a 10% haircut in a very short period of time. You know, if you're ever up 14 grand on the day, you can't let a $14,000 losing winning day turn into a losing day. So that's a crying shame there. And then we had Raphael P, another live trader, up $3,400 earlier this morning, turned that into a $3,000 losing day. So overall, it's been a pretty good week from our group of funded traders, our live traders especially. The board doesn't look that great today. You know, when we have big movements like that in the morning, when most of our traders are active, as well as most of the participation and volume in the markets, you get a big move to the upside or downside like that. Anybody with exposed positions on that's, you know, not positioned the right way and doesn't have protective stops in, as I like to say, they got smoked. So that's what happened. It's a shame. You know, at least for Rafael S, even though it was a large percentage haircut on his overall account balance, he's still in pretty damn good shape with that heavy account balance. So other than that, a lot of traders today on the boards, you know, up small four-figure numbers. So I'm not even going to go into commenting on those for the sake of time. But I think we dive right into the cards. Speaking of good performance on the week, I'd love to kick it off with one of our traders, Cameron, a live guy. We got his trading card up here too. Cameron's live, his net P&L, so he's in a live account. His net P&L, you can see, is minus 22 bucks a day. So overall, negative trading. He has spent 118 trading sessions in this live account. And I wanted to feature him today because there's kind of a lot to unpack here. But Cameron is someone who, like I said, Jack, spent a lot of time in the live account, 118 days. And over those 118 days, they've averaged losing $22 a day. They've been up, they've been down, they've been all over the place. But Cameron is actually a trader of ours who decided that, hey, after all this time, it's not really working. And he voluntarily closed his trading account after all this time. That account has been open since, actually don't have the start date on it offhand, but enough to have 118 sessions under his belt. And recently, he's gone on a bit of a losing streak. And
January 8th is the first entry, I say.
Yeah, a little bit of a losing streak, and January 8th of 2023. Yeah, that makes sense. So I'm not even going to really go into all the metrics that he has here. What I wanted to talk about was his smart decision making and his ability to say, like, hey, this isn't working. I want to just exit, take a break, pocket the money that I do have left, as opposed to just going through and burning through the account. And you and I, we've talked about it a bunch, and I've seen it many more countless times where, you know, someone with a very healthy account balance, their strategy is not working in the current market environment, and they just keep fighting and keep fighting and keep fighting and keep fighting. And they burn through a lot of good money with bad trading in very short order. So after 118 days in this account, I think he totaled about 17,000 in payouts during that time. Now, his decision to close that live funded account yesterday, while he still had 25 grand left in the account, I really like, because not only have I seen, you know, traders here doing the wrong thing, I also have many, many horror stories from just time being involved in this industry where, you know, I know of, you know, some people that had at one point had very high net worths that had to seek life elsewhere outside of the business because they kept doing what they used to do despite it not working and didn't have the, I don't know, the discipline to stop really or scale things down. So this is a big shout out to Cameron. I hope that he can take some time to reflect on, you know, what he was doing and make some adjustments to it. You know, as far as reflecting on what he was doing, like, I hope he's just taking the money, regrouping. He could have, you know, obviously kept the account and just said, guys, I'm going to take a few months off. I'm going to enjoy summer, clear my head and come back. That would have been fine. But what he's doing also is fine. He's got a big sample size of metrics here, many of which that I peppered into the trading card. We see, you know, the clearest thing here is average winning day of being only about $780, while the average losing day is more than that, you know, to the tune of like $600 more than that. So he's risking $1,325 on his average losing day while he's only taking down $780. With the sample size this large, it's really easy to hang your hat on where you need to make some subtle adjustments going forward. Because, you know, if you could, I don't know how many losing days he had, but his he was 62% winning days. So 38% of his losing days, if you could, what's 38? I'm not going to do the math in my head while I'm on live TV, but call it what's 40% of 120 losing days. It's like 48 losing days. If you could make, so I did the math, simplified it a little bit. If you could take a $600 difference and apply that to 48 trading days, we'd have a very different view at what this account balance would be or what the performance would be. So extrapolating small little tweaks like that over time, it adds up to a lot. Now that might be math that I don't want to do in my head. So 600 times round it up to five, you know, that's $30,000 difference right there, right? Yeah, you get the idea. It's a $30,000 difference, a little bit less than that over time. But if Cameron's watching today, I mean, that's something he should be thinking about as well as every other trader. You know, we talk about small adjustments adding up to big things over the course of, you know, a trading career, an account. And, you know, there's way more, there's far more than 118 trading days in any given year. Calendar year. So that's just, that's almost half a year right there. If you, you know, were involved in almost every session, you could say that 30 grand turns into 60 grand if you just extrapolate. So play with the math a little bit, but yeah, I commend him for stopping and taking the payout. So the 17,000 plus that he took during the live account versus the $25,000 payout, you know, I view this as somewhat of a success for him.
Cameron took payouts, and, you know, you do the math. I think it is a good decision. That's a huge sample size, 118 trading days. But, you know, the total losses, you know, $22 or whatever else. I mean, like, that's only he didn't lose that much. So he lost, like, a couple thousand or something total. But if it's not working, and obviously you can see all the products traded. I was clicking around right there seeing if these were like one-off things, but it seems like most of these products he gave a decent shot at, tried some different things. And if it's not working, I think nothing wrong with taking the money.
And that's okay. And, you know, if I was on with Andre right now, I know one question he would ask and it'd be like, you know, what do you think about someone trading all these different products? And just because he's got all the equities, the energies, the metals in here, currencies too, doesn't mean that he was trading those every day. You know, this is a long period of time. The account's been open for over a year. So if you don't see opportunity in one market, go find opportunity in another market. You know, that's a beautiful thing about electronic trading. You can cherry pick where you're going. So anyways, I wanted to share this because I thought it was an interesting story that maybe not a lot of people think about, because I hear a lot from, and I'll end it at this and not go long in the tooth here, but I'll end it at this, is I hear from people that say, I know I can do it. And they're not realistic with themselves and looking at their performance and honest enough to say, it ain't working. I'm going to take a break. I'm going to take what I've got, move on maybe. I don't know what he's doing. I know one of the other risk managers spoke with him about this. I personally did not. So, you know, I don't know what he's doing, but I commend him on what he did, and I think it's a big boy decision here to stop when it's not working. That's what we all need to do, and very few people have the discipline to do so.
Well played. Well, let's go quickly through this next card. We have one more regular card here with Francisco, I believe.
Yeah, let's talk about Francisco. So I was kind of happy to share Francisco because he's not been in the account as long. He's got 16 days in this account, and he's a trader. Metrics are looking good here on some of them. Others, we need room for improvement. So someone with 63% winning days and 67% winning trades, I love that. But their average losing day is larger than their average winning day. I like that the best day is better than the worst day. I like that they're selective with their trades on a daily basis. The risk reward here is pretty backwards at 1-3. You know, they're risking 1600, mm-hmm. almost 1700 bucks to make 500 bucks. That needs to change. But why I wanted to talk about Francisco was he started with 20 grand in the live account. And early on in the account, the first half of his trading in there, so he's at 16 days. Today's 17, I think. He was in a big drawdown. He got cut in half, Jack. Got cut in half in his first 8 trading days. 20,000 down to 10,000. That is psychologically something that's hard to come back from. But I'm very happy to share that he's up 4 grand today. And that puts him on a 8-day, $18,000 win streak, or heater, as our good friend JD would say. 18,000 bucks in 8 days. And I like that a lot, because that's just like, put your nose to the grindstone, true grit. It's not easy to come back from getting cut in half, and to come back, you know, obviously he's in tune with the markets, and he's pressing, which is always good. When your strategies work and you press, when it's not, you pump the brakes, you scale back, or you take some time off like Cameron did. But I just wanted to give him a big shout out here today, because I love seeing people that have gone through some hardship or drawdowns, you know, turning things around. And I mentioned he started with a $20,000 account balance after he came from his XFA. Now he's at 28 grand. So, you know, after getting cut in half to making new account balance highs, 8 grand higher than where he started over the last 9 trading days, it's really good stuff.
Yeah, maybe you can always set your own personal limit on these. I want to say we were so close on this card, Francisco, to a pure club DLL. Took one losing day of it was just one trade that day where he lost $270, and that was the only one that wasn't a DLL. So close, yet so far only the pure. Yeah.
I'm happy you pointed that out. We see a lot of that with these 150K account sizes, Jack. You know, personal loss limits are a big thing. And just because we say you can lose 3 grand doesn't mean that you should. Yeah, 3 grand on a $20,000 account it's a pretty big chunk or percentage, I should say, of your overall cushion that you've got. But anyways, big shout out to him. Jack, I know you are chomping at the bit to roast a little trading here. Are you ready to move on? And Juan, why don't we take a look at this? All right. Juan submitted himself for some analyzing the trades, aka roasting my trades. And I'm happy that you're here for this, because I'm not good at roasting people. I'm pretty good at talking shit, but roasting and making it fun is a different art form. So what I do have here, you know, he's got a good number of winning days in his current XFA, but you know, the best winning day was, I think, 530 bucks or something like that, while he's got his daily loss limit. It's always a problem when people are risking, you know, multiples of what they're taking out of the markets. And I thought this is how funny I can get. You know, Gordon Ramsay would say that this is garbage or this is shit. So, yeah, I'm not that humorous of a person. And I think another thing I saw is all these winners, they're like three-figure winners where the losses are bigger. And he's in an XFA right now. He's got other trading combines going. But like I see these trade reports for Juan, and I'm like, this guy's kind of gun-shy. You know, if you're not familiar with being profitable on a regular basis, you're going to be pretty quick to pull the trigger and get out of trades that are winning that might become larger winning trades. And chances are those people are a little bit more patient. So I saw, and I could be wrong, but it seemed like they were a little gun shy about being in profitable trades and didn't have the confidence to stay in them and let them run for them. So yeah, that's it. Yeah. And I'm here. I got my popcorn ready, Jack. Take it away.
This may not be my most informed effort, but let's start with a few things here. First off, I don't know Juan. And all I saw was one trade report that's 9 days. And the first thing, before I get into this, that came into mind on Juan is, like, are you familiar with the Reddit, the subreddit, like, Roast Me, where people, like, put pictures and then people comment whatever roasts, which are usually just absolutely brutal. It reminds me when somebody, like, a super attractive woman goes on there like, oh, roast me. Or, you know, like, if you had that friend back in the day that was, like, super hot, that was like, oh, I'm, you know, like, I'm so ugly or stuff like that. Because he sent us this card in, like, the last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days or winters. Okay? How do I roast that? Well, I'll tell you how, as a matter of fact. Because there were 9 days of count, and the first 4 days totally sucked. So let's walk through this a little bit. As I commented, like, the first 4 days in his account, Juan was playing the retail version of, like, the Lehman Brothers explosion. To the point is he lost $79 the first day, made $25 the second day, lost $50 the third day. What do you think he did on the fourth day, Mick?
Daily loss limit.
Lost 10 times that. Lost $1,025.80 on the fourth day. You pulled the opposite of Michael Burry's whiteboard. Congrats on that, Juan. As Mick pointed out, he's holding winners for an average of 51 seconds, to which I have to ask, Juan, are you trying to beat the machines out of a misplaced sense of pride? It seems like maybe you read the first 90% of the John Henry story and thought, hell yeah, humans rule. He died at the end, Juan. And the steam-powered drill didn't give a shit. It just kept making money. Nothing was gained. Of course, Juan is trading the NQ and NMQ, which is the preferred contract of every trader here who holds trades for under a minute. Mick, have you seen Toy Story?
Oh, yeah. Big okay. fan. Buzz Lightyear, Woody.
Woody. Well, there's some other characters, too. So this goes out not just to Juan, but a lot of our NQ traders. Some of our traders are like those little inflatable aliens in the claw machine, you know, like the claw. And the NASDAQ, it's the claw, you know, but it's but the NASDAQ is the claw. So they're just like, you know, NASDAQ. And like those aliens, when the NASDAQ or the claw gets a hold of them, they're ecstatic until they get blown up by a stick of dynamite minutes later.
Sid.
Sid blows him up. Jerome Powell is Sid in this example. I'll keep going. When a child touches a hot stove, they learn not to touch it again. I swear to God, if some of our NQ traders touched a hot stove, they would empty their bank account trying to find and buy a hotter effing stove. NASDAQ, guys. Some of you guys have an addiction. But anyway, as I mentioned at the beginning, Juan is on a 5-day winning streak. So maybe, just maybe, he's turning it around. Juan, good luck. Godspeed. Thanks for submitting. I'm sure you're a wonderful person, but those first 4 days, you gotta stop that. That's not good.
Yeah, and thanks.
And that's what I got on Juan.
Thanks for being a good sport, Juan. If I could, exactly. While we still have 1 minute before we need to kick it over to the next segment, how'd my old man fare on who wore it better? What the results of that poll?
That's a good question. Let me take a look. Okay, who has the better stash? Mick, you won, 63% to 36%. So be sure to bring that up at the next family gathering.
Well, I think I could flash him right now, 63 to 37.
Well done. All right, well, stick around. Mick, awesome to have you back. Look forward to talking. Hope Europe was a blast. Everyone else, stick around. We got group coaching next with JD and Robert.